1864, on a cold November's morn, the burning of Atlanta was a sad and a dreary one. For Sherman came a-marching with 100,000 men, and through the smoke, through the flames, over the cannon's roar, you could hear them rebels call, "We ain't scared of y'all. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again. We're tough as nails and they better turn tails and hit back where they've been. They took our beans and a fat back pony. We still got our Confederate money. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again." Johnny Reb's now in retreat, but fighting till the end. With nothing left but the burning past, it's gone with the wind. For Sherman gave the order, burn Atlanta to the ground. And through the smoke, through the flames, over the cannon's roar, you could hear them rebels call, "We ain't scared of y'all. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again. We're tough as nails and they better turn tails and a hit back where they've been. They took our beans and a fat back pony. We still got our Confederate money. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again." The war between the North and South is just a memory. The burning of Atlanta has gone down as history. But let us turn the pages back to the time of yesteryear, when through the smoke, through the flames, over the cannon's roar, you could hear them rebels call, "We ain't scared of y'all. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again. We're tough as nails and they better turn tails and a hit back where they've been. They took our beans and a fat back on it. We still got our Confederate money. We don't care what the Yankees say, the South's gonna rise again."
Situation. Resistance continues in the heartland of the Confederacy. Mission. Crush that resistance by forced march from Atlanta to the sea. Execution. Lead a force of 60,000 infantry and 5,500 Union cavalry. Administration. By order of the Commander-in-Chief, President Abraham Lincoln. Command.